she cats and her parakeet, with rats running round the size of caribou, playing peekaboo with her filthy feet, eating donuts with a spoon and drinking oval tea through a scum of green, floating leisurely in a coffee cup of plastic from a Sally Ann, shaving in her hand out of misery. And it's all because she didn't eat her vegetables.
It's
all because she didn't eat her vegetables.
Vegetables!
It's all because she didn't eat her vegetables.
That's a kid.
Behind the shack without a bed, with his battered head resting on his knee, as the roaches and the traffic sang a lullaby, the water pipes would sigh a little harmony, with the stogies he had found wrapped up in cellophane, to keep out the rain. When the night was through, he would stumble down the alley picking junk sometimes, or try to beg for dimes on the avenue.
And it's all because he didn't eat his vegetables. It's all because he didn't eat his vegetables. It's all because he didn't eat his vegetables as a kid.
As a seamstress never brought in much, cause she lost her touch in a codeine haze. Now she staggers in a stupor through the city streets, wrapped in ratty sheets from her sewing days. Her crazy little face is hidden in the shade of a hat she made from a cardboard box. The hair beneath her hat is so in need of care, it doesn't look like hair. Like dirty socks.
And it's all because she didn't eat her vegetables. It's all because she didn't eat her vegetables. It's all because she didn't eat her vegetables as a kid. Or maybe didn't chew them properly if she did.
One more note. Her uncle come to see her in his tattered clothes, with a runny nose and a pint of wine, and a bucket full of bullheads he had caught that day on Monona Bay with a handheld line. She'd spread a little blanket on the apple crate where they always ate when they had the food. They would eat, they would drink, and when the grub was gone, they would carry on.